this just in. Otters are adorable and dying.
But otters are our future.
I know when I was a kid, we didn't have to worry about drugs and AIDS and kids bringing guns to school. I can't even begin to imagine what otters must face today.
Humans!
Conflict!
Humans and otters both use coastal waters and can get caught in fishing nets and lines.
And also can be hit by boats.
Lately, otters have been getting sick from protozoan parasites such as Toxoplasma gondii and Sarcocystis neurona.
How do otters get Toxoplasma gondii?
I heard that they got kids in dolphins.
Ugh, dolphins are gross.
Choose a line.
Low genetic diversity. Otters in California have low genetic diversity due to intense hunting for their fur in the 1800s.
Bang, 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 bang!
Today's otters descended from only a few individuals. This makes them susceptible to disease and changes in their environment.
Perfect.
Pollution!
Chemicals can make their way into the ocean and accumulate in otters, making them more susceptible to disease.
There's also the ever-present risk of
oil spills.
Toxoplasma gondii.
I think we all know someone who's been affected by T. gondii. It's a pretty serious disease. So I am doing a 5K run this weekend. Try to raise awareness and get some money for research and charities. Should be a pretty good deal.
Babies, babies. Toxic gondoplasma killed my babies.
I lost my mother to T. gondii about 5 years ago, and my father took it very hard.
Cats are the primary host of Toxoplasma gondii. It's only in them that oocysts are developed, that you are resistant to the environment and passed through their feces. Other mammals can pick up the oocysts and ingest them from the environment. Bradyocyte cysts form inside these mammals as secondary hosts. If another cat should eat that, that cat may then become infected with Toxoplasma gondii. Once again, passing oocysts in its feces, releasing them into the environment. Rain and freshwater runoff can then carry the oocysts into the ocean. They make their way into the marine environment. Recent research suggests the oocysts may be picked up by bivalves such as mussels as they filter feed to become concentrated in the tissue. Otters then eating the mussels and other bivalves ingest oocysts, thereby becoming infected themselves. The protozoan parasite Toxoplasma gondii, once ingested, can form cysts in the otter's brain, making them more susceptible to shark attacks by altering their behavior or causing meningeal encephalitis, killing them directly. This is a shame because otters play an important role in the marine ecosystem. Urchins consume kelp, otters consume the urchins, helping to keep their populations down, thereby preventing them from deforesting the kelp forest, preventing erosion and maintaining biodiversity.
Yeah, I heard of Toxoplasma gondii, and I don't want my baby retarded or nothing. Yeah, my boyfriend wouldn't change the cat box or anything, so I'd get rid of my cat. You got a light?
Yeah.
Me and those otters know cats are trouble. I got my baby to think about.
If you don't keep your cat inside, you're lame. If it doesn't help the otters, at least it will help the environment because they won't be eating birds. And by the way, your cat will be happy too.
Otters are cute, but my cat's cuter. When it meows and wants to go outside, I can't say no.
I'm Eris Houghton, and I'm a fourth grader at Carmichael Elementary School. We've had a lot of fun today talking about Toxoplasma gondii and how it affects otters, but it's time to get serious. Every 2 minutes in California, another otter dies, and it's your fault.
You thought you were a clever girl, giving up your social world, but you can't come back, be the first in line. Oh no, you're